Hi, I'm Melissa Wheeler, a senior lecturer in management. My research and teaching focuses primarily on applied ethics and leadership, including teaching a unit about what leaders need to know in order to deliver effective change initiatives. And today I'm going to be talking to you about women in leadership for the AGSE's Innovation and Ideas series. We've all seen the statistics showing an underrepresentation of women in the workforce, and in leadership roles in particular. But what you may not have heard is why this is an important inequity that we need to address. In this video, I'll cover three key points: why we should care about increasing female leadership, some common myths about women in leadership, and how 2020 has led to differences in what we expect from our leaders. Recent research has helped to build a strong business case for why we should care about increasing women's involvement in leadership. And by leadership here, I mean in management, on boards, as CEOs, and in government. For example, boards with equal representation of men and women are more likely to reduce the gender pay gap within organizations. And increases in women in leadership roles have been associated with greater profitability and productivity. But some of the barriers that keep women from progressing into leadership are kept in place by a set of myths that play on gender role stereotypes, or a set of expectations of the roles that women and men should fulfill: men as breadwinners, women as carers. Myths such as women don't want the top jobs, or that women with children don't want a career, have been busted in evidence-based research time and time again, but continue to be used to justify imbalances of men and women at the top. Challenging these myths when you hear them is one of the most powerful tools for combating their influence. And to my last point, the events of 2020 have been a great catalyst for change. We can see that in our new expectations for flexible work arrangements, in our shifts to online shopping, and in what we now expect our leaders to be. Valued leadership qualities now include honesty, transparency, compassion, and even humility, all qualities that tend to be associated with feminine traits. In addition, we've seen some amazing role models, including New Zealand Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern, and lots of social media about empowering women following the passing of Ruth Bader Ginsburg. Change is in the air, and female leaders may be better placed now more than ever to deliver what people are looking for.